with us each and every day.
Thanks be to God.
My screen's not moving. Brand new computer, first day. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome. I'm humbled and privileged to stand before you this beautiful Sunday morning. The Lord has given us to worship together. Let us take this opportunity to thank our Heavenly Father for allowing us to be here as we listen to the Word of God to feed us. We also thank each and every one of you for finding the time to come and fellowship with us here. Let us also thank the visitors present, those attending our service online via Facebook, YouTube, and welcome you all in a special way and tell you that this is the place to be. Make this your place of worship. As we start the service today, feel at Jesus' feet. And may the love of God be with us all. No matter who you are or where you are in life's journey, you are welcome in this place. Not just by me, but by the God who was revealed in the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus. Welcome to St. Paul United Church. You are safe in this place. As we gather to share in this time of worship, let us pause to remember that we worship in lands that are by law, the unceded lands of the Mi'kmaq, the ancestral territory of the Mi'kmaq people. May we live with respect on this land and live in peace and friendship with its people. We have a few announcements. They've been gathering up. I'll try to get them in without missing too much. On Tuesday, 12:30, the Marion Union is going to be meeting at Maureen Roddick's house. And at 1:15 to 3:30 on Tuesday, the quilters will be in the parlor. Quilters will be in the parlor again on Wednesday from 11:45 to 1:30. I'm reading two lines at once. The quilters will be in the parlor between 1:15 and 1:30, and the community lunch will be at 11:45 to 1:30. And this will be the first community lunch for the season. We're first on the agenda, so ours is this week. And there's also a sign-up sheet out in the narthex for anybody who's able to volunteer, either on Tuesday evening or on Wednesday to help out. On September 10th, our talk of the town topic will be kids first. On September the 10th, the church council meets at 2 p.m. And Ivy Terrace will be at Ivy Terrace at 2:30 p.m. September 13th, fundraise committee at 6:30. September 17th, our back to church Sunday, and there will be a barbecue. On the 22nd and 23rd, there is a book sale downstairs, right? Downstairs. Food bank, with school starting, lunch type items would be appreciated. And then the normal canned goods are always appreciated. A fundraising update. Thank you to everyone who supported our recent fundraisers by donating, setting up, and helping at them. All the other tasks that were needed. We made $5,805.25 from yard sales. $1,047 in the roof fund donations, and $390 from the concert. A total of $7,245.65. The companion circle, I only see two of you here that belong to it, Wendy and Maureen. If you'd meet with me just for a couple minutes after the service, I'd appreciate it. And the new laptop was working a few minutes ago. It's working up here, so you're not going to see the difference, but I can. So I'll ignore this and try not to break it. We really want to appreciate, if you recall our last service in July, I kind of dropped it. But to be honest, it was not a great loss. You know, it had to go. But through anonymous donations, within a week, we had a new one.
Wow.
And I'm very appreciative of that, and I'm sure Mary is going to be as well. The one we had was way too small for the things we were trying to do with it. And we used it to its limit. So thank you very much, anonymous donators. Donations have been made to several funds of our church in loving memory of Lynn Blankford. To the Roof Fund from Helen and Tim McLeod, Gina Snell, Marilyn Joyce. To the General Fund by Dot Kelly, Margaret Grant Walsh, Evie and Albert Monroe, Maureen Roddick, Jerry Quinn, Wendy Monroe, Nina McNeil, Norman and Gordon McLeod, Don and Dorothy Lane Hale, Aileen and Will Sutherland, Joe, Nancy and Cameron Doyle, Gordon and Mary Lynn Cameron, John and Diane McDonald, Russell Lois Lewis. Russell and Lewis, my tongue just won't work, Hensby, and Ann Blankford. And to the Outreach Committee by Jack and Pamela Cannon. Donations have also been made to the General Fund in loving memory of Jim Connolly by Russell and Lois Hensby, Albert and Debbie Monroe, and Joe and Nancy Doyle. Let us join in our call of worship, which is our new creed. We are not alone.
We live in God.
Prayer together. Let us pray. O God, who is our strength, you have protected us from those who seek to oppress us. You have shielded us from those who seek to destroy the good gifts you have put in us. Your love and your power never fail. Thanks and praise to you, our safety and stronghold. We exalt you, O God, majestic in holiness. For there is none like you. Amen. For those who support our church financially through PAR, e-transfer, or any electronic means, and those who continue to contribute in other ways, we are very grateful. You make our ministry possible. Let us now present our offering. Thank you. prayer for wholeness and renewal. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, you lived for us. We have not lived for you. You have forgiven us. We have not forgiven others. You have loved us. We have not loved ourselves. Nor have we loved one another. Take pity on us. Forgive us. Help us to forgive. Help us to live for you. Help us to love through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear these words of assurance. People of God, you are forgiven. God is merciful and gracious, and is Lord of us all. Reconciled to God who loves us, let us live and love through Christ our Lord. And all the people say, thanks be to God.
Amen.
Our first hymn, Jesus, Friend of Little Children, Voices United, number 340. Scripture God speaks to each of us. Let us listen now for the voice of God. Amen. Jesus continues teaching and preparing his disciples for the days that will follow and the things that will happen. Reading from Matthew 16, verses 21 through 28, and today I'm reading from the Inclusive Bible. Listen for the words of Jesus. From that time on, Jesus began to explain to the disciples that he must go to Jerusalem to suffer many things at the hands of the elders, chief priests, religious scholars, and that he must be killed, and that on the third day be raised to life. Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. Rabbi, never, he said. This will never happen to you. Jesus turned to Peter and said, get yourself behind me, you Satan. You are trying to make me stumble and fall. You're settling your mind on the things of, you are not settling your mind on the things of God, but of mortals. Then Jesus said to his disciples, if you wish to come after me, you must deny your very selves. Take up the instrument of your own death and begin to follow in my footsteps. If you would save your life, you will lose it. But if you would lose your life for my sake, you will find it. What profit would you show if you gained the whole world but lost yourself? What can you offer in exchange for your very self? The promised one will come in glory of Abba God, accompanied by angels, and will repay all according to their conduct. The truth is, some of you standing here will not taste death before you see the coming of the promised one. It's raining. bless to our understanding the reading from the Holy Scriptures. And all the people say,
Thanks be to God.
Our second hymn, O Master, Let Me Walk With Thee, Voices United, number 560. Shirley believes every day is a gift and another opportunity to be a difference maker by letting your light shine, no matter how big or how small. Speaking in public is not her comfort zone, but she has willingly agreed to come today to speak to us about the Pictou County Council of Churches, which is near and dear to her heart. So welcome, Shirley, and thank you very much for coming and doing this presentation for us today.
Thank you. pleasure to be with you this morning. Thanks to St. Paul's Worship Committee for this invitation and opportunity to come and speak today about the Pictou County Council of Churches. I was also asked to tell a bit about myself and my involvement within the Council of Churches, in my church, and my community. As you have already heard, my name is Shirley McKay, and I am a long-standing member of Scottsburg United Church, which is one of three congregations in the pastoral charge of Salt Springs, Scottsburg, Lions Brook United Churches. And we are truly blessed to have our minister and spiritual leader, the Reverend Jim Weber Cook. Church has always been an important part of my family's lives, and I have been both grateful and thankful for this faith-filled community. Over the years, I have been actively involved in the life of the church, including the development of our pastoral charge mission statement in 2003, which was a declaration of what we believed ourselves to be as a Christian community. And it was out of this mission statement that our faithful actions would flow. Our mission and our ministry that we continue to live out to this day. Within our pastoral charge is a small group of dedicated and enthusiastic members who are called the Faith in Action Team, of which I am a member. This team strives to assist the pastoral charge to live out and put our faith into action and fulfill our mission statement by being aware and responsive to those in need. With the ongoing generous support of church members, we are able to take on various projects and support numerous organizations and causes working towards greater justice for all and supporting our brothers and sisters, both locally and globally, in the way Jesus taught. Over the years, the projects have been many, including, but not limited to, Ryan's Well Foundation, where approximately $10,000 was raised to build three wells in Uganda. Coldest Night of the Year Walk, where since 2015 we have raised $26,514. Canadian Foods Grain Bank, where $7,200 was realized to provide food and support to third world countries. Every year, we have a Fuel Fund Sunday, when church members, if they wish, make a donation for the benefit of the Pictou County Fuel Fund. We also support Viola's Place with food items and gift cards. Each year, for the past number of years, during the season of Lent, our spiritual practice has been to set the table for Lent, whereby each Sunday of Lent, church members donate food items as they are able for the local food banks, just as they do on the third Sunday of every month when we have Food Bank Sunday. Pre-COVID, we provided, prepared, and served meals twice a year at the Shepherd's Lunchroom. We have discovered that in this ministry and our outreach beyond our walls, that there is abundant life for us and a sense of vitality for all our congregations. At Scottsburg United, I am also a member of the church choir, of our UCW, and I also sit on the Ministry and Personnel Committee of our pastoral charge. In 2015, I became the lay representative for our pastoral charge on the Pictou County Council of Churches and served as the council's representative as a board member of the Pictou County Fuel Fund for 7 years. I continue to be on the Council of Churches, and my responsibilities now include being a member of the newly formed Mission Committee. This committee recently met to discuss ways to enhance Council's purpose and provide support to local charities and organizations and new initiatives, as well as ways to increase awareness of what the Pictou County Church Council of Churches is all about when we reconvene in the fall, which is quickly approaching. As the lay representative for our pastoral charge, it is my responsibility to provide a written report and update of the work of the Council of Churches at each official board meeting, as well as provide an annual report. Throughout the year, during a Sunday regular or combined worship service, when we normally have minutes for mission, various groups and committees within our church present what is called Minutes for Ministry, which provides up-to-date information and details of each of their activities. This past April, at a combined worship service, I provided the following regarding the Pictou County Council of Churches, and was subsequently asked to present this today at St. Paul's United Church. Minutes for Ministry, Pictou County Council of Churches, abbreviated PCCC. Well, some may ask, what is the Pictou County Council of Churches, and why does it exist? To give you some background history, the Council of Churches has been in existence for 50 plus years. Ecumenical churches within the county decided to come together to seek and promote unity between different Christian denominations for the purpose of sharing ministry, deepening their relationship with God, and celebrating God's presence in the world. Called together by the love of God and the desire to walk the way of Jesus. The Council of Churches and its membership work together for the greater good, seeking and promoting social justice for all, and helping to benefit our brothers and sisters in our local communities and beyond. As we all know, change is an inevitable part of life, and living the past 3 years with COVID has changed our world immensely. In the midst of great change, it became evident to the members of the Council Executive that perhaps with these ever-changing times that the Council of Churches needed to reassess and evaluate the purpose and the need for our existence in the community. As a result, the structure of the Pictou County Council of Churches was reviewed and the process began for developing a new strategic plan, as well as reviewing and amending the Constitution and bylaws, which had not been looked at for many years. I'm pleased to say that this has been successfully completed and there has been positive restructuring, particularly of the committees and their responsibilities, as well as clearly defining their roles. Corporate prayer leadership and support during our meetings has been very positive, knowing that the Holy Spirit is guiding us as we move forward by renewing our strength with a sense of purpose to be Christ's followers and to go make a difference in God's world. The Pictou County Council of Churches membership consists of both clergy and laypersons and meets quarterly on the first Tuesday during the months of March, May, October, and December, while the executive, which oversees the work of the committee, meets during alternate months. Each council meeting is hosted by a member church or local institution, with the opportunity for coffee and conversation prior to the meeting being called to order. Every meeting is open with prayer and devotions, followed by committee reports, new business, and a guest speaker for educational purposes. The Pictou County Council of Churches has a long history of showing concern for the welfare of residents of Pictou County. As many of you are aware, it was the Pictou County Council of Churches that established the helpline, which continued for 33 years before closing in May of 2016. Currently, there are provincial-wide helplines in place for people seeking assistance, direction, and information. The Pictou County Fuel Fund, as well as the Food Bank, were established by the Pictou County Council of Churches, and although both are now standalone organizations, the Council of Churches still supports them through Fuel Fund Sunday and other fundraising initiatives throughout the year, as well as communication by members of the Mission Committee and upholding them in our prayers. At each meeting, Council receives reports from its committees, which include Social Action / Social Justice Committee, which is a small and very diligent and active committee that has the pulse on what is taking place in the county and beyond that is of concern to residents. They keep council informed and advocate on the many pressing issues that our communities are facing, hoping to influence change. Some of the important matters they have been involved with include, but not limited to, our Citizens for Public Justice, Pictou County Aging Well Coalition, Low Income Housing, Health / Mental Health, and Anti-Racism. This committee needs and is looking for new members to help them in the important work they do, as they are often the voice of those less fortunate or marginalized living in the county. Communication and membership. Primarily still in the developmental stages, with the hope of soon establishing and maintaining a social media presence. Spiritual Care Committee. This committee works with the Pictou County Health Authority, overseeing and ensuring that spiritual care of patients is provided. Due to COVID during the past 3 years, this was disrupted, but I am pleased to report that it is returning to normal. Mission Committee is responsible for interacting and communicating with 12 or more various groups and agencies in Pictou County, including the Pictou East and West Food Banks, Viola's Place Society, Pictou County Fuel Fund, Cody's Place, Shepherd's Lunchroom, Tiernan House, Summer Street Industries, Roots for Youth, Big Brothers, Big Sisters, St. Vincent de Paul Society, and church camps including Camp Getty and Salvation Army, as well as possible new groups such as Kids First and a Furniture Bank of Pictou County. A letter was hand-delivered to each of these agencies to let them know that the Council of Churches is available to assist them in the work that they are doing. Prayer Committee. Council considers prayer as essential to the very essence of who we are as a Christian body, and is therefore an essential part of the life and work of the Pictou County Council of Churches. Over the years of the Council's existence, prayer initiatives were undertaken and continue to this day. For example, churches pray for churches, as you see each Sunday in the worship bulletin. Clergy prayer meetings occur monthly. Members of the Pictou County Council of Churches pray for each other, both privately and corporately, if requests made by a member. Pictou County Council of Churches regularly pray for the many community groups and organizations whom we are connected with. Speaking of prayer, I wish to share a cute quote that I recently came across and feel to be very appropriate in this day of modern technology. It goes like this: the best wireless device is prayer, always connected and no need for Wi-Fi. All of the above is a mere snapshot of the work that continues to take place within the Council of Churches for the benefit of all. Each meeting is closed with prayer, followed by a luncheon and fellowship provided by the host. This was the essence of my presentation to our pastoral charge, but since then, our annual general meeting was held on May the 2nd at First Presbyterian Church in Pictou. During this meeting, the installation of new officers and committee conveners took place. In closing, I would like to draw your attention to this poster, which says, God calls us to deep spirituality, bold discipleship, daring justice. This thought-provoking poster was made by a church member of our pastoral church. I feel this speaks to what we need to be about, and I believe it is also fitting for the work and ministry of the Pictou County Council of Churches as we strive to make a positive difference in God's world. It is an exciting time to be a member and part of the life and ministry of the Pictou County Council of Churches, and I encourage churches and individuals to become involved if they are not already. Over the past 8.5 years, it has been a privilege to represent our pastoral church, and I am grateful for the opportunity to witness firsthand the important work carried out by Council, expressing Christianity by lovingly serving God together through their work, whereby helping benefit others in our communities and beyond. I look forward with excited and hope-filled anticipation in the months ahead, with a sense of renewed purpose and direction, continuing the important work which God's Spirit is calling and guiding us to do. Thank you for your attention and the invitation to address your congregation and wider community. God's peace and blessings to each and every one of you. This concludes my presentation, but if there is anyone that has any questions, I will try my very best to answer them. Thank you.
Once again, we see that God is definitely present and working throughout our community. Let us pray. To you, O God, we pray. To you, we lift our hearts and voices. For your forgiveness, O God, transcends whatever wrong exists between us. Grant us the courage to forgive others and to practice reconciliation by the kindness of our speaking, the sharing of our resources, and the honoring of your desire for good. We praise your abiding guidance, O God, for you sent us Jesus, our teacher, Messiah, to model for us the way of love for the whole universe. We offer these prayers of love on behalf of ourselves and our neighbors, on behalf of your creation and our fellow creatures. During her time of renewal and rest, we offer our prayers love for Reverend Mary and her family. We ask that through your continued love, she gain inspiration and regeneration of the Spirit as she grows. We ask that you continue to give our community of faith the courage, love, commitment, and support that we can grow in our love for you, and by that also for one another. We especially ask for your blessing on the family of those on the families of those members of our community of faith who have passed since we've last met. Give ear to our words, O God. Listen to our cry. For all leaders of nations, give humility and wisdom. For all servants of Christ, give faith and love. For all victims of violence, give justice and peace. For all captives and debtors, give forgiveness and freedom. For all people who suffer, give healing and hope. These things we pray by your word and spirit. May your will be done. God of compassion and care, we pray silently for those we hold in our hearts this day. Source of all light, we praise you for the wisdom of your word and the hope of your promises. With all of your saints on earth and in heaven, we commit ourselves to the dawning of your new age. We pray together as we were taught, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us closing hymn, He Leadeth Me, Voices United, number 657. go from this place knowing that you are loved by God, who waits patiently for you. Surrender your life.